Hello, railroaders. My name is Jim Lyle. I'm pleased to once again present Dallee products to you. Dallee Manufacturing has been in business for a long time, manufacturing quality products in the United States of America from components made now all over the world. Today, we're just going to review some of the things that are so easy to overlook when new things come out. We're going to point out real quickly the E unit. This is the 400 E unit, replaces an E unit in most of your post-war locomotives. This is good for 4 amps. It doesn't have a sticky drum, it doesn't burn fingers. It's easy to install and it's absolutely reliable. We have the 10 amp E unit in this unit. This unit has 2 motors. They are can motors, obviously, but this will also run most open frame motors. If you have 2 open frame motors pulling more than 10 amps in an O gauge or a G gauge locomotive, I'm going to suggest you look for issues. We have the 12 volt VPS, which is a regulated power supply. We're using this on the S gauge layout here at the museum. In fact, we've been using the same one since at least 1994 when I started to volunteer here. We have the track DT, which is a digital timer. There's also a DTT, DTL. Each one has a specific purpose. Everything is laid out very well in the Dallee catalog at www.dallee.com. The instructions in the book were written by trained people for trained people, unlike the instruction book that might have come for your cell phone. It's probably not intelligible to anybody in this country. The Dallee's instructions are understandable and workable, and there's a strong dealer network and factory situation where if you have a problem or a question, you make a phone call. The lighting that we're showing here, these cars originally would have had incandescent lighting in them, little light bulbs that drew a lot of amperage, that flickered when they went over a switch, flickered when they went over a little bit of dirt. These cars have the Dallee lighting strips in them. They come in 2 sizes, the 10 and the 18. The 10 is $34.95. They're easily installed. If you put super caps on them, this 18-incher, I'm going to pick off the track, and I hope that the camera will show you that even though it is off the track and away from the track power, the car will stay illuminated for a period of time, which could indicate a station stop, just indicate the car's going through switches, over dirty track, whatever. The lights stay lit. This car is showing a fluorescent-style lighting, which Amtrak cars would have had and do have. This car is the mate to this car. This one has the original factory lighting in it, which you can see is very... Oops, it went out. I'm sorry. Oh, that's right. It would do that. It's incandescent. There's no backup power source to it, and it's very poor lighting. As I said, this car, the cool white indicates a fluorescent lighting like you would find in modern commuter cars, in your modern Amtrak trains. This is a warm white lighting, which would have been in your car, such as on the Pennsylvania, the New York Central, whatever. These cars were powered off of the locomotive. These cars were powered by batteries underneath the individual cars. All of these products are available, as I said, either through the strong Dallee network of dealers or from Dallee. Once again, the email address is www.dallee.com, and I thank you very much.